27 April was supposed to be the end of apartheid. But I can tell you now, there is no apartheid that ended in South Africa. If anything, apartheid has been financialized, where they used to be the signs that said non-Europeans are not allowed here. They've been replaced with a high amount of money. When you want to buy a house, you don't qualify for a bond. When you want to buy a car, you don't qualify for finance. When you want to open small business, you don't qualify for finance. When you want to go to the university to further your studies, you don't qualify for finance, especially in the universities that were attended to exclusively by white people. Today, you want to go and swim. If you don't have money, you will never go and swim because you are unemployed, because you are suffering from poverty. The reason I'm saying those signs were replaced by finance, they make everything expensive to keep black people out of the places which they never allowed black people before. Today, you claim to be free. How can you be free when we are going through hunger? What is this that you are saying about being free when more than 40% of young people of South Africa are unemployed? Today, many of our people do not have land. Many of our people do not have homes. Racism is still the order of the day. The exploitation by a capitalist system against the African majority is still the order of the day. We take this opportunity to commend and appreciate the marvelous and impactful work that was done by our ground forces from Musina to Cape Town. You went to send this message to all our people that is not yet Uhuru. We still have to fight for another day. Comrades, we are here as the EFF to report here without any fear of contradiction that EFF is present and alive in all corners of South Africa. Fighters, I'm the only one who can tell you that because I've been to all corners of South Africa. In the last 3 months, I visited our people everywhere where they are found in South Africa. And today, as we conclude our campaign, I want to say to you, I am very happy that the EFF can be found in all corners, including the dorpies of Northern Cape. Comrades, we want to say that our people must come out in their numbers on the 29th of May. If the youth of South Africa come out on the 29th of May, we will collapse the government of criminals. Fighters and ground forces, don't be discouraged. You have fought a good fight against all forms of disinformation and lies told about your movement and your leaders. You never got discouraged. You continued to fight. Even when the media was not on our side, you did not listen to a white old capitalist media. You did door to door to spread the message of the EFF. Comrades, you have thus far demonstrated that you can be relied upon. Let us all increase the momentum because we are approaching the finishing line. Today is not the end of our campaign. Today, we are here to recharge and go back to our villages to conclude the finishing line as the leader of society. President of the Youth and Student Mobilization, we are very proud of the work you are doing. The Mulungisi Madonsela Battalion is shaking the whole of South Africa. The youth of South Africa is once again more interested in the coming elections. These elections belong to you, the youth of South Africa, and the youth of South Africa will determine the outcome of these elections. No young person in the whole of South Africa should associate with a failed liberation movement. If you are young and following the dying liberation movement, it is your own problem, because that movement only belongs to people who have attempted suicide in their lives. If you have never attempted suicide, don't go to the ANC, because you'll attempt suicide. The problems of the ANC are so many, to a point that all young people who are associated with the ANC are suffering a permanent depression. Fighters, we have gone to this election under the clarion call. Our land and jobs now, stop load shedding. We launched this campaign in KwaZulu-Natal. We went to the homes, we went to student residences, we went to workplaces, religious institutions, village crawls, to speak to our people about the call for true freedom. But let me remind you that this was our message, but it was spoken by many voices, but the message remained one. None of our leaders deviated from the message. None of our leaders wanted to outshine other leaders. None of our leaders did their own program outside the program guided by this message. We were always guided by a principle that says many voices, one message. And we successfully executed that. We have heard and understood the people of KwaZulu-Natal, that many areas in the province of KwaZulu-Natal, particularly Umkhanyakude, Umzinyathi, Ugu, Zululand, and many other areas do not have access to clean and drinkable water. Vanhu va le Giyani na Malamulela, hina va nhlangano wa EFF hi ta tisa mati and hi ta khoma swigevenga leswi nga tsandzeka ku tisa mati for more than 20 years. A Giyani hi ta aka yunivhesiti yentshwa, hi ta tirhisa Giyani College of Education ku aka yunivhesiti ya manyunyu a Giyani. We heard the people of Phoenix in eThekwini that for more than 30 years they've been excluded from housing allocation, and instead of building unity, political parties that have been dominant continue to divide them. We've listened to the young people of Mpumalanga, in Bushbuck Ridge, in Komazi, Emalahleni, Dr. J.S. Moroka municipality, that they need the land and jobs and they want them now. We've heard the people of Mafike, Bujanala, Dr. Kenneth Kaunda and Dr. Ruth Mumpati district, that there are levels of suffering due to poverty and joblessness must come to an end. We paid attention to the young people of Gauteng in the township and in all institutions of Harleni, that they want free quality and decolonized education, and they want it now. The youth of South Africa have said, when you take over, you must immediately declare free education and declare free Wi-Fi in all institutions of Harlem. The youth of South Africa have said the allowances that are paid to the students must come directly into their pockets every month. The youth of South Africa have said they don't want NSFAS. They want us to pay directly to the university, because NSFAS is the corruption of Blade Nzimande and the Communist Party. Fighters, we heard the people of Orange Farm, of Alexandra, of Deep Sword, when they said that despite the 30 years of the so-called freedom, they still do not have decent shelter and houses. We've heard the people of the Northern Cape in all the regions that they want the mineral resources and mineral wealth that is underneath their soil to benefit the people of Northern Cape. The people of the Western Cape have said to us the open fact that the white government of DA does not care about the colored and black communities in the Western Cape. They said we must not only remove the corrupt ANC, we must also remove the racist DA, which is exploiting and oppressing our people in the Western Cape. Comrades, the people of the Eastern Cape live under very difficult conditions, with unemployment being the highest in the whole of South Africa. There are still mud schools with pit toilet in this Eastern Cape. We have heard the people of Ndlambe, Makana, Nelson Mandela Bay, Buffalo City, Mthatha, Butterworth, Flagstaff, Lusikisiki, that they want to live in a country without crime and unemployment. The people of Eastern Cape said to us, please hire more police to come and look after our communities, because there is also a problem of stock theft. People of South Africa have said to us, when you take over, please remove the corrupt police who are distributing drugs using the fans of the police. You must take them to jail for no less than 25 years. The people of South Africa have said, we must take criminals toe for toe, because the murder rate in South Africa is too high. The people of South Africa have said, if a person takes out a gun and points that gun at a policeman, that person must say goodbye at home, because that day he's going to meet his maker. Comrades, we have been asked by the people of Soshanguve to come and rescue Jukule. There is a place in Soshanguve called Jukule, where even police are not allowed. We are promising that on the day we get inaugurated here in South Africa, we'll run a huge military operation in Jukule and all areas that are affected by drugs, nyaupe, and gangsterism. Comrades, no one must tell lies. There is no province that is run correctly. You can't say Western Cape is run correctly. You can't say any province of the ANC is run correctly. Eastern Cape is even worse. Their premier went to steal a degree from Fort Hare. He went to steal a master's. Now they are tired of stealing money. They are stealing qualifications. So we need to stop those criminals in the Eastern Cape. Comrades, we must make sure that we proclaim here that we are ready to lead the government of South Africa from now onwards. We are ready to fight all kinds of criminals in our country, including the corruption of the politicians. No politician will be left unattended. Comrades, when we take over South Africa, we are going to open Palapala, and we are going to raid Palapala, because we suspect there are more dollars left at Palapala. We said to you, the president has dollars under mattress and in the sofas. You said you are lying. The president said himself 4 days ago, I'm going to pay back those dollars to the buyer. Wagwar lukhodru le tswere ka morwalo. Benke be re ska bolela uri una le di dola na ka se di patele. Ani yo lo o ro di patela le khodu ka uri EFF e mo expose je hore ntwe ke le khodu e robala u di ma di dola. Ija I duti o di ma di dola. Comrades, I declare in front of all of you here and in front of all the progressive forces of South Africa, Africa and the world, that I will do everything in my power to bring about economic freedom and common prosperity in our lifetime. I commit that when I'm president and head of state of South Africa, I will not be involved in any form of wrongdoing and corruption. I will protect our natural resources and I will grow our economy to create millions of jobs for all our people. I'm not a sellout. I don't have a history of selling out. I've never sold any of my friends or comrades or any of my fellow fighters out. I've always demonstrated loyalty to those who served with me in the trenches. I commit to be loyal to the Constitution of the Republic of South Africa and make sure that the Constitution does not serve only those who are associated with white monopoly capital. Comrades, I come to you with a formidable and reliable team of revolutionaries and professionals who are committed to change. I bring to you the Deputy President of the EFF, who is ready to become the Minister of Finance in South Africa and take care of our people. Comrades, I bring to you the Premier of KwaZulu-Natal, Marshal Dlamini, who's ready to take that province and make sure that we lead it with precision. I want to commit here that we will not hire people in the people's government who are politically affiliated only to the EFF. Whether you are ANC, whether you are DA, whether you are EFF, you must still have the South African ID and have the qualifications. Only then you'll be employed in a position where you are suitable. Comrades, when the EFF is voted into government on Wednesday, the 29th of May, we are going to schedule our inauguration on the 16th of June in salute of the 1976 generation. If you want us to celebrate the 1976 generation, and if you want us to give them the honor they deserve, elect the EFF on the 29th of May, because inauguration day, it is on the youth day. It is not a mistake that we chose a youth day, because the youth are going to determine on the 29th of May who becomes the government of South Africa. Comrades, when the children were falling on the 16th of June, it was Winnie Mandela who went around picking up bodies. It was Winnie Mandela who called ambulances, who drove children herself to the hospitals. The inauguration on the 16th of June, it will be a dedication to Winnie Nomzamo Madikizela Mandela. We say to Winnie, we are continuing with your militancy and your radicalism. Your children have multiplied. If there is any doubting Thomas that you have inspired a lot of young women, you must listen to our DSG articulating the position against GBV. You must listen to our national chairperson when he commands the meeting of women and women's programs in South Africa. Look at the Treasurer General, who has looked after your finances, which led to the procurement of a head office that is now named after you, Winnie Mandela headquarters. Mama, we salute you. We do everything in your name and in your honor. We go around, engage different types of people, but we know every time when we walk around that we are the representatives of Winnie Madikizela Mandela. Today, we must all go back and remind all of our gogos, all of our mothers, that 29 May, it must be dedicated to Winnie Mandela. 29 May, we must say to Winnie, they did not make you president. The president we deserved, but your children can come and close that vacuum, because nature does not allow a vacuum. After my inauguration, I will immediately increase social grants for all grandparents to more than 4,000 per month. After my inauguration, I will increase the child support grant to 1,200 per month. After my inauguration, I will immediately send highly skilled teams of professionals to resolve the water crisis facing our communities. We can commit here that there will never be a community within the first 12 months of our government that will not have access to clean water and drinkable water. I'm here to declare that there will be water in all parts of South Africa. When we take over government on the 16th of June 2024, we will start the process of insourcing security guards and general workers in all government institutions, and there will never be a government worker who's going to be paid less than 10,000 per month. There will never be a government worker who does not have medical aid. There will never be a government worker without a pension fund. There will never be a government worker who does not have the leave days. When we take over government, we'll ensure that there is no crime in South Africa. We are declaring a war against criminals. We are declaring a war against rapists. We are declaring a war against GBV. South Africa shall be a place of peace. South Africa shall be a place of law and order. How do you prove that? Look at this event of the EFF. There is law and order. There is discipline amongst the members of the EFF. Comrades, when we take over, we will improve all the health facilities and ensure that all clinics open 24 hours every day. We have assigned the Gadi Artemis to go and help that woman who gave birth outside the clinic in Sukukuni because it was closed at 4 o'clock. We said they must go and help that woman to sue government. We want the government to pay because the child passed away. Comrades, we know that during the course of these elections and before, many right-wing and neoliberal organizations spread lies that the EFF will encourage illegal immigration and will immediately open our borders. It's not true. There is no border that will be opened immediately. We will work on it gradually because we have a duty to unite the whole of Africa. It's not something you wake up and just say, I don't care about what is here. Comrades, there will not be an illegal immigration in South Africa. There won't be a person without documents. Everybody in South Africa will be documented. Whether they came here for whatever reason, we're going to be an Africa-friendly government where those who come into our country, they will feel obliged to come and declare their availability in South Africa. We are committed to Pan-Africanism. We are committed to regional integration, but that does not mean that we'll encourage illegal and undocumented immigration. Everyone who's in South Africa must be documented. The EFF encourages you to take IDs so that you can be documented. How can we say the people who don't come from here must not be documented? When we said the people of Africa must come into South Africa during COVID and find the creative ways into South Africa, we were talking about those workers who were locked out of South Africa, who had documents and who had the right to be in South Africa. We are not ashamed of that statement. Every African who has got a contribution to make in South Africa, this is the home of all Africans, and all Africans will be accounted for. Every time you speak about undocumented South Africa, undocumented people, you refer to Africans. You don't talk about the Chinese, you don't talk about white people, who are many in the Western Cape, who are undocumented, who are illegal in South Africa. Let us not make Africa and a black skin an easy target. You talk illegality, let's let it affect everyone. Comrades, that's what I said. You will have law and order. And undocumented people is not law and order. We will retain order in South Africa and we will fight to grow the economy of Africa, because that is the only way you are going to keep these Africans where they stay. If you don't help to grow the economy of Africa, we'll still have a problem of immigration. We will not succeed alone. We must succeed together as the African continent and ultimately become a borderless Africa with one president, one currency, one military command, one parliament of Africa. So, don't go around listening to people who are suffering from scaremongering. Barmalimaka tsena Mazimbabwe la tlotla ka moka na ke lwele Mazimbabwe ke ba re shumala ke re ba eta mabambiri ba tsantjwa le mabambiri ba ba sna mabambiri re ta malukise ja mabambiri o re tsebe gore ke ma bo South Africa fellow South Africans ditsotsi tse di suspendile load shedding for 2 months. They did so because elections are coming. Under the EFF government, there will not be any form of load shedding, not just for 2 months, but forever. There will never be load shedding in South Africa. Vote for electricity on the 29th of May, and please make sure your vote against load shedding. It is only the EFF that will bring to the end any form of electricity shortages and cuts. The EFF will not close the coal power station. The people of Mpumalanga and of Waterberg Lephalale region here in Limpopo must never be worried about their jobs and livelihoods. They are safe under the EFF government. The EFF government will firstly work with nations with skills and expertise in energy to enter into build, operate, transfer BOT agreements where coal and nuclear power stations will be built for purpose and handed over after the time the state, once the nations have resolved and recovered what they've invested. We are going to speak to China, we are going to speak to Russia, we are going to speak to all progressive forces to come and build power stations in South Africa. They can build them and operate them, but after 30 years, they must hand them over to the state of South Africa and exit South Africa. That is the only way we are going to guarantee electricity supply. We will establish a state-owned mining company to manage coal mines owned by Eskom. This will guarantee a steady supply of quality of coal at an affordable price, essential for the operation of our power plants. We will expand Eskom generation capacity. We will not privatize it, putting an end to chronic shortages that have plagued our country for far too long, and will do away with the disastrous policy of privatization, consolidating generation, transmission, and distribution under one unified company to streamline operations and improve efficiency. We recognize the importance of embracing renewable energy sources. That's why we will pursue a diverse mix of energy sources, including clean coal, gas, nuclear, and renewable like solar, wind, and hydro energy. Additionally, we will introduce a municipal conditional grant to support municipalities in implementing hybrid and off-grid energy solutions, promoting local energy resilience and sustainability. Comrades, under the EFF, all schools, clinics, hospitals, and police stations will be electrified. Comrades, under the EFF, there will not be a single home without electricity. Because we can afford to put electricity in each and every house. Comrades, under the EFF, we'll create millions of jobs and remove our children from the streets and rescue them from alcohol and drug abuse. We are the only party that plans to create full employment for everyone who's looking for a job. Other political parties, including those in provincial and national levels, are only planning to solve less than 20% of the job crisis in South Africa. Young people must read the manifesto of all the political parties and will realize that it is only the EFF that aims to create full employment and it will be quality jobs. We will create state-owned construction companies, state-owned roads company, state-owned housing company, and through these millions of jobs will be created as we need to fix our roads, we need to build houses for our people, and we need to rehabilitate our railway links. Here in Limpopo, there are opportunities for jobs in agriculture and livestock farming, in infrastructure development, and in tourism. And once the EFF takes over, we'll develop schooling system and create employment opportunities in all of those sectors. We are going to ensure that the massive development of factories and industries happen to ensure that we manufacture developed products and completed product, finished products in South Africa. Comrades, we are going to make sure that no government department retrenches the workers. Any department that seeks to retrench the workers is going to be the enemy of the government of the EFF. We are going to rescue the post office. We are going to rescue the SABC. We are going to rescue Transnet. We are going to rescue PRASA. We are going to make sure that Dinel continues to function, because Pravin Gordhan is going to be history after the 29th of May. Pravin Gordhan has collapsed all the state-owned enterprises. Basha, Batoyando, Mutale, Shayandima, Musina, Malamulele, Nabafuani, Bakotu Damishumo, Bohanganea, Kausa Shuma Fezi, Auna Mishumo, Bohanganea, because Mishumo Iko Fiwa ma-ANC. So the EFF is going to make sure that the youth of Collins Chavani, the youth of Tulamela, the youth of Makado get jobs in all those municipalities. We are saying to our people, you must never fool yourself and say, Cyril Ramaphosa, Diwayani, Haunamutwange, is not from amongst us. He's a sellout who did nothing for the people of Vembe and for the people of Limpopo. So we don't know Cyril. That one belongs to Minel family, belongs to Oppenheimer family, belongs to the Rupert. He does not belong to us. Comrades, we are going to give uniform to all our children in schools. We must make sure uniform is free of charge. And at TVET colleges, we must make sure and university that the courses offered are relevant to our economy. Why is there no short courses which teach us poultry farming, pig farming, goat farming, and vegetable farming? Why is agriculture dominated by ZZ2 in Limpopo? We are going to bring to an end the domination of ZZ2 of our agriculture economy and of our land. Comrades, we are going to give our people houses, and our houses are going to be in good condition. Our houses are going to have 3 bedrooms. Our houses will have a dining, a kitchen, and a bathroom inside with a flushing toilet. Akelebotse maaka maabane re tsofa kokura makgole le mokgalabo a kitlile le bona mo mokala bwa u disabled ke tshoba fanto ya maema o dimo mavan ke be ke nyaka o le bontsha hore roga di ntlo tse di jwa re le EFF a ona ntlo e ka tshoka metsi a ona ntlo e ka tshoka toilet ya flasha a ona ntlo e le muri e ka sebe le motlhase di ntlo ka moka o tsana le ntlo ya go bura makhone yo ba le passage ka mwane go redivide di activities rofa bana dijo ko dikolo re ba fe breakfast re ba fe lunch he ba fita kae ba tlo kriya sapa ka re oketsa tšhelete ya bokoko to 4,000 and re oketsa tšhelete ya bana to 1,000. Comrades, ba ka no le botsa maaka ba re ba le tlišetša NHI. NHI ke phori matlhong a se nnete. They are just saying you are going to go to the hospitals free of charge. They are lying. They were signing it because it was an election gimmick. They were playing with the feelings of our people. We will introduce a national healthcare system that will have clinics that operate 24/7, that will have ambulances, that will have doctors, that will have nurses, and will ensure that those clinics do not close at 4 o'clock. This story that they are unemployed doctors will come to an end. There will never be an unemployed doctor in South Africa. So I want to say to you again, eba ka re bolela maka le ba botsa re ma yona beke he ya u fita re tso bula clinic ya u bula 24/7 kwa Johannesburg municipality re bula le MMC wa rena. So a re bulela fela a re di di promise re di a di commitment. How shall I EFF morao? How shall I the promises re u shala commitment morao? Comrades, baskal u jamaka a re bulela ka Winsosa the security le di cleaner re dile ka kwa Johannesburg municipality re dile ka Wits University and many other universities with our student mob command, with our fearless young people. The cleaners in most universities are insourced. Under the EFF, they are all going to be insourced. We want them insourced even at the University of Limpopo. We want them insourced at UNISA. We want them insourced at TUT, at Capricorn FET, and all the FETs. Comrades, 350 elali kirian rekasi kantsel itswela pili mara lo thoma o ikriya o ya ka di qualification alisa tongola o lekana a hona uri muthu abe le matric a fiwe chelete ya o tsona lo asina matric re tlodia ntwe ri bitsa ngore ke graduate grant. Ke o ka tsena sekolo ba so fe mereko wa demonstrator ke galo o maketa re tlo tshwanela ko ropa tele lo re o tswa sekolo. There is what we call graduate grant that is going to be given to the youth of South Africa. Comrades, I am not here to launch a manifesto. I am here to conclude the campaign of the EFF. I am here to say to you, we have run a good race. We are here today because we ran a very successful campaign. The ground forces of the EFF have made everybody aware that there is a child called the EFF who must be given an opportunity to lead. Comrades, we must go back home now and go and continue to convince our people. Comrade Fani, your mandate from Lukis Matonse is to make sure that each and every member of Mulugis Matonsela Battalion brings no less than 20 people out on the election day. As the youth, as the students, don't go to vote alone. You must make sure that you bring no less than 20 people with you to go and vote for the EFF. Bring your parents out, bring your cousins out, bring your siblings out, bring your friends, your neighbors, colleagues, and everyone to come out in their numbers to vote for the EFF. For these remaining days, we should all intensify the work. No one must leave here and say, no, we are done. Our rally was successful. We have already won the elections. We have not won the elections. We are starting now. We start from here. We are marching straight to Pretoria to take over the Union Building. Fighters, any of the leaders who lie and say they are party agents when there are no party agents, that is counter-revolution. You are not different from planted spies. Any leader that says there is transport and the transport is full and the TG must pay and pay for things that do not happen, that is counter-revolution. We must go out and take our voters out and transport them to the voting station. Do not lie. Do not over-impress. Be honest to the organization so that we can help you where there are shortcomings. Do not play a hero. Do not seek personal glorification. Do not seek personal praise. Work honestly and work for the movement. And at all times, tell the truth and nothing else but the truth. Fighters, this is the time of the party agents to take over. A party agent is a person who is punctual. A party agent is a person who's dressed properly in a respectful manner. Party agents must have communication skill, including communicating nicely, even to those who don't vote for the EFF. You can't be a party agent and be rude. You must love your people. You must hug them. Even if you know that this voter said he's not going to vote for EFF, put them in the EFF transport, because you must become so familiar with them such that when they arrive there, the ANC voters, out of your politeness, but remove pilot one is men like a moot. Kaur Utabe Ogitsuri Abuzi. Comrades, Rakubela, Razi Baur Morina, Unalaba Mobile Jacob Zuma, Bausisibedi no moro. Yalo and Yalo, the party agent, Unagadi no moro, Tibedi no moro, Otebotaka Chaga Speedy. Obabutore, I stop and to Wasiona are recounting again. So you can't be a party agent without a numeracy skill. You have to know the palo. Usinye ile lojedi awutswa eba kagira o satsi di palo bo bethana mo peleao wa bethela matsobo code. Comrades, you must report honestly. A party agent cannot leave a voting station before counting is concluded. A party agent must not sit at the door when they are counting. You must see each and every ballot that they are counting. And if the electoral officer says you must go and sit at the door and not observe the counting, you must stop that counting. You must disrupt that counting until the seniors are called to come and intervene. No one must stop a party agent from seeing each and every ballot paper that is counted. When they say EFF, EFF, ANC, if you don't see proper lot, bring it back. I didn't see the ANC. Let me see. We don't want cowards to be party agents. We want fearless fighters. Kiatsiba, Uri, but vale the presiding officer. Baba Mama Bonabe, the principal at Jalina. Banitsiba, Mafogodi Alina. Levala Jewe, Uskamu Chava, as the principal. Halikua, the presiding officer. When I was a student, Omusadi, Omuna Omuzi, Opapa Watu, to allow Chava presiding officer. Take them head on and defend the pilots of the EFF. Comrades, please make sure you execute this responsibility with care. I want to say to all our guests who came to greet us, thank you very much. We support you and you must continue to fight. Our victory on the 29th of May is a victory for the people of Palestine. We are going to vote to liberate the people of Palestine. Palestine shall be free if the EFF is the government of South Africa. The EFF is going to remove the Israeli embassy in South Africa. The EFF will not allow any company to sell products from Israel. The same goes to McDonald's, Pick and Pay, Truworths, everything, Woolworths. We don't want products which have got blood of innocent women and children of Palestine. The people of Palestine, do not get discouraged. We are coming to join you to fight for your self-determination. Comrades, as I conclude, I want to thank our leaders all over South Africa. I want to thank the ground forces of South Africa. I want to thank the officials of the EFF, and special thanks to our Secretary General, who was serving as a national coordinator of election. I've never seen a man who works on a detail like our Secretary General. He will give you information readily available on what is happening, where, and who is responsible for what. So, all of you comrades, you worked very hard. Go back to your provinces where you are deployed as leaders. Come back to us with victory. When you come back from your deployment, please don't come to Masakane. I will be at Union Building. Arrive at the Union Building. That is my new address. That's where you're going to find me when you come from your deployment. I want to thank my beautiful wife. I want to thank my three children who gave me an opportunity to come and serve the people of South Africa. They allowed themselves to be fatherless for the last 3 months. Every man with a strong woman next to him is bound to succeed. My wife is very supportive. My wife is always encouraging us to do the right thing. My wife is up there by the grandstand with my three children. One of them is called Ratana. On Tuesday, he was distributing EFF T-shirt at St. David's there, and the whites were shocked. It's all in the family. I'm not saying he's going to be a leader. Don't kill him young. I'm just saying he knows he has to serve his people. My family knows that we don't boast about anything. We humble ourselves and we don't demand VIP status where we go. We don't display opulence because our people are struggling. When you display opulence in front of the rest of the poor masses of our people, what are you saying to their poverty? I was saying to my wife that if I don't arrange a special transport for my three aunts who are here, who have been loyal to me, who have always supported me and appreciated everything, I was telling her that if I don't organize transport for them, they are going to go into the EFF buses. They will never demand any special treatment because our grandmother did not bring us up like that. We were always asked to be very humble. When I was telling her the story before we came here, we were watching TV. The next thing we see Manitra Fina on TV with the masses going up and down. Organize the transport board. Ukamola utshwere flaga una le masses. Why? We come from a humble family. I say to my mother-in-law and all of my in-laws, continue to encourage your child to do the good thing. We are encouraged to call you as family. Today, you are sitting here with our big family. We are nothing without this stadium. These people are what make us to be who we are. Comrade Deputy President, we have done everything humanly possible. We have been everywhere. We have spoken in different languages. Comrade Deputy President, we have followed the manual as was presented before us. We have gone door to door. We have done conversing sheets. We have spoken to South Africans. There is nothing we have not done to speak to the people of South Africa. Now it is in the hands of the people of South Africa. Now the people of South Africa must decide if they want unemployment. They must decide if they want load shedding. They must decide if they want to remain landless. The people of South Africa, it is now in your hands. We live here very proud that we did everything to make our generation very proud. All of you who are here, your names will be called when the books of history are read, that you took a stand and said you are going to fight for economic freedom in our lifetime. Let's go out, let's go in our numbers, let's mobilize our people, the ground forces of the EFF. Now is the time for economic freedom in our lifetime. Now we have a responsibility to vote for the government of the people, for the people, to vote for the people's education. Amanda! 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 Viva, Iapa, Viva! Viva, Iapa, Viva! Aule, Iapa, Aule! Aule, Iapa, Aule! Tata, Iapa, Tata! Tata, Iapa, Tata! Aule, Musa, Mauko, Lowe! Aule, Musa, Mauko, Lowe! Awe muso ramaphosa we. Awe muso matabata we. Forward to victory, forward. Forward to victory, forward. Nyaba sabana. Nyaba sabana. Nyaba sabana. Nyaba sabana. Forward to victory, forward. Forward to victory, forward. Long live the entire spirit of Peter Mukaba, long live. Long live the entire spirit of Peter Mukaba, long live. Long live the entire spirit of Winnie Mandela, long live. Long live the entire spirit of Winnie Mandela, long live. Long live the entire spirit of Christian, long live. Long live the entire spirit of Christian, long live. Come on. Oh no, Magumi. Siaya. No, Magumi. Siaya. No, Mavese Tubola. Desishaya, desibopa, no mabese tobola, desishaya, desibopa, kumi kumi yo, siaya, siaya. Winnie Mandela, Mandela, Winnie Mandela, Umama wait, Peter Mukaba, Mukaba, Peter Mukaba, Umama wait, Sofa Skichi, Emoye, Sofa Skichi, Etati, Kichi, Kichi, Kichima, Zipram Konto, Alliance, shoot to kill, Yamasa, shoot to kill.